welcome. Welcome to the Austrian residence again.
Thank you.
Tell me a little bit about your life. Were both of your parents artists? Because you are in the arts field and your brother is a musician?
Yeah.
None of them?
None of them.
None of your relatives?
Some of my relatives are musicians or are musical, I would say. But none of them has a career that I've chosen. I went to school in Linz and then right after I went as an au pair girl to Paris. I had time off on the weekends. And those times, I always would go to museums. I just would discover mm-hmm. a museum landscape that I have not experienced
before. Paris is very rich. It's incredible what Paris has to offer in terms of museums. I remember that.
Yeah, it was really enriching and wonderful.
So that sparked the interest?
Yes.
You would say?
I would say, yeah. I realized pretty soon that my love for the arts was bigger than anything else, even though I love the languages as well. That's kind of a moment where things developed, I think, you know.
And you could feel that you were passionate, that yes. was what you were passionate about.
Very much so.
If you're passionate about something, then you, sooner or later, you will be very good at it.
Yes. And I didn't know what to
do.
I didn't know what to do with it. I just loved it, you know, and I was so curious.
And you figured out.
The good thing is there's always new things to see, so it's never boring. Yeah, in a way, actually, during my studies, that's how I met my husband, who is an artist in Vienna.
Steven, I know him.
Yeah, so we met in Vienna, but we had different lives. He still lived in the United States, and I eventually got a job right after finishing my studies in Vienna, mm-hmm. making my master's there. I got a job in Germany to be the assistant for a curator at a Kunstverein in Wolfsburg, in the city mm-hmm. of Wolfsburg. That's where Volkswagen is from.
Why did you not stay in Wolfsburg?
Good question, right? I could have stayed there. I mean, my job was open-ended. That was not limited. But I felt after 5 years and me coming to this at a very young age, I wanted more. Sounds crazy, maybe, but I really wanted more for myself as well.
It doesn't sound crazy for a diplomat who has to move every three to 4 years and is curious to learn more things and do new things.
And
so I perfectly understand.
Yeah, and I really liked Berlin as a city as well. That mm-hmm. that city opened up also many new universes, I would say, and I met a lot of new people there mm-hmm. and decided... asked Stephen if he would consider moving to Berlin with me, and mm-hmm. so we both moved to Berlin. And I started to go back to university and work on my PhD.
By the time you finished your thesis, were you already thinking about moving to LA, or did that come afterwards?
My husband Stephen, as a California boy, he wanted to come back to the sun. And Berlin is not very sunny.
I cannot blame him for that.
It's not very sunny, especially at least 6 months out of a year is not sunny at all. And we had to make a decision between New York and Los Angeles. Mm-hmm. And we visited both places. I've been to New York before as well. But I really fell in love with Los Angeles because I felt it was so different. New York was a bit more similar to Europe.
It's much more European, mm-hmm. yes. That's true. Apparently, looking at your career, you found what you needed in LA because you've had really important steps done since your arrival.
I did, and in a way, looking back, it's clear when you're in it, you don't know it, but, you know.
Of course. Yeah.
Uh-huh. And I wrote my PhD and eventually a book. That became a book in German mm-hmm. and then also in English
yes.
on movies.
I do have it.
and on movies on artists. So that was for me also already a link between my two worlds, the visual arts and the movies. And I was fortunate enough to spend a lot of time with that subject matter to figure certain things out or to think things through. Mm-hmm. I was also able to do some interviews with directors in America for it. So, you know, I created my own little links, I would say.
But you accumulated a lot of wisdom through the process of writing also.
Maybe, yeah. And that was mm-hmm. basically, that time I really wanted, after 5 years in Wolfsburg, I wanted time to absorb things, to mm-hmm. learn things, to mm-hmm. increase my knowledge.
LA definitely is a very fertile ground mm-hmm. with respect to arts, to the arts,
yes,
right?
Very much so.
The Max Center is a very very important institution when it comes to creating links between Austria and Los Angeles. Yeah. I know that many, I mean, maybe not many, but several of the artists, the Austrian artists in residence who had been at the Max Center, then came back to organize an exhibition here with contacts they had created while they were here as artists in residence, right?
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, so. And there's a program that supports that too in the Max Center as well. And last year I brought two artists together in that respect also. Karina Nimmerfall, an Austrian artist who had a grant here. She was invited to come back and she asked me, we are friends now, and she asked me for advice of who would fit well with her, you know, as a dialogue. And I thought of an artist of a different generation than she is, Morgan Fisher, and it was like a perfect combination.
So you brought them.
It brought them together. They really made a very beautiful exhibition there and also had a good time together, you know.
Great, Doris.
Yeah.
Thank you. You're doing my job.
Yes, we're both doing similar jobs, you know. We just have different outcomes maybe, but the practice sometimes is similar, right? It's it's a social network in real life.
Talking about bringing people together, we even had one project together.
That time I was at the Skirball Cultural Center. I was a curator there.
I remember that you set up a beautiful exhibition called Light and Noir.
Yeah, it was an exhibition. It was a historic exhibition looking back and creating an awareness for an American public that German-speaking exiles and emigres that included people from Austria, from Germany, from Hungary at that time, from Czechoslovakia at that time. So it was like the cultural field of German speakers in the late 20s, early 30s was much larger than it is now. And and so it was a very interesting...
You mean as a percentage of influence here in, in Hollywood?
And the exhibition really was about the so-called golden age of Hollywood, as we call it, the 1930s and 40s, were largely influenced by German-speaking exiles and emigres who most of the time had to flee from the Nazis from 1933 onward, first in Germany, then also in Austria and other countries, and then came here, managed, if they managed to come here, and if they managed to have a career. Not, of course, not everyone did manage that, but I could focus on the ones who did have a career.
Like?
Fritz Lang, Billy Wilder, I mean, those we all know and cherish, but also composers. Max Steiner, Erich Wolfgang Korngold, definitely, Erich Zeisel. So there's so, I mean, there's such
Walter
a rich...
Walter Jürmann.
Yeah, Walter Jürmann, exactly, yeah. There's such a rich legacy, and once you start looking into it, it just opens up a big field, which was really exciting to dive into. And also to create a way to communicate this in an interesting way, in a, I mean, fun, I wouldn't really say, because this topic is not necessarily fun, but I called it light and noir. So it was also about comedies and film noir and two ways of communicating with each other in a way. The wonderful thing I was really happy about is there was a different space I could also program and invite an Austrian artist.
Yes,
I thought that would be
exactly
a perfect
that's
combination.
Where we come in.
That's how we met also. And you, the Consulate General, was so kind and supported the exhibition as well.
It was my
pleasure. And it was really helpful and wonderful to have that connection. And then on top of it, you, the artist Isa Rosenberger, who I'm invited to develop this project called Café Vienne, which first only was a video project to kind of a resurgence or to a renaissance, you know, looking back and bringing back somebody who might have been forgotten. In her case, it was Gina Kaus, an Austrian writer.
I remember that,
yes. She came to Hollywood and had a career here, but people
didn't
know her.
She was very famous in Austria.
Very famous in Austria.
And I remember that you set up a Viennese coffee house.
Yeah.
There was a Viennese coffee house setting at the Skirball Center. <in it. laughs>
Because we don't have coffee houses here, and I always miss that part. I still miss it, actually. So it is a cultural space of coming together. And that space that we had for it was kind of perfect for it.
It was perfect.
So,
it was perfect. I remember that I connected you with the Austrian-American Council West.
So Veronica Reinold and Liliana Popov were with you, and you brought them together because you thought they could be interested in that project too. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And that was a wonderful combination for all of us.
And they were, right?
They were.
They could help out.
Yes, they did. They also supported the exhibition, thankfully. And
great.
And they created, you know, a nice collaboration, I think, and a nice way of bridge building between mm-hmm. cultures, but also between generations, mm-hmm. I felt. And also communicate to an American audience what we bring to this,
yes,
as Austrians.
Exactly.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
And as far as I remember, if I'm correct, it was the exhibition that you organized at the Skirball that helped you get your following job at the Motion Picture Arts and Sciences.
Yeah, yeah. It's a long title.
Which we only call it the Academy, and we mm-hmm. know that this is the organization that stands behind the Oscars. That's where you now work.
Well, now I'm an exhibition curator at the Academy Museum of Motion Pictures.
Yeah. And the opening of the museum, tell me a little bit.
The museum should open in 2019, mm-hmm. and it's being built right now as we speak, every second of it. And the architect is Renzo Piano, an Italian mm-hmm. architect who has built a lot of museums in America and around the world. Mm-hmm. So he's a very seasoned museums architect, which is great. It's a historic building, so the facade will be renovated, mm-hmm. which is also great and rare in Los Angeles that things are renovated and not torn down.
Yes, I know.
So I'm glad that a landmark building will be a different kind of landmark, but will have a history here, and will house the museum with exhibitions and a restaurant and a shop, you know, all the things you have in museums nowadays. But really
a large
space of exhibitions in the old building, and the movie theaters will be in the new building. There will be two movie theaters. I think it will be a nice combination of film lover material and popular material, mm-hmm. I would say. It's fascinating being part of something that is growing and is being built, and being part of a team that is figuring things out. You know, it's not always easy, but it's fascinating. Mm-hmm. There's only one museum in the United States that exists so far, which is MOMI, the Museum of the Moving Image, in Queens, New York.
Coming back to the links between Austria and Los Angeles, I bet you know other Austrians, successful Austrians who are here. Do you know others who are in the arts fields?
At the Getty, I know two mm-hmm. Austrians that also became friends of mine. One is Alexa Sekira, mm-hmm. Who is the head of the scholars program at the Getty, where I was attached to when I had my scholarship. So that was very
wonderful. That the moment when you met her? Or was she not there yet?
Yes, she was there.
Okay.
Yes,
mm-hmm.
she was
mm-hmm.
there already.
Yeah.
She was already there. Yeah. And then Christian Huema,
yes.
who is the so far has been the head of the provenance department there,
yes.
at the Getty Research Institute, but now has a path back to Austria.
Uh-huh. To become the head of the research center at the Belvedere.
Yeah.
Congratulations to him.
Yes.
Great step.
Yeah.
So if you could give any advice to Austrians who are in the arts field, what could help them to move to Los Angeles, to get a hold of Los Angeles?
Yeah, one very good way for an artist or an architect is to apply for a Max Schindler grant.
Mm-hmm.
That's how you can come here for half a year.
Mm-hmm. And stay at the Max Center,
Max Center, you mm-hmm. have an apartment. You have an exhibition at the end, and you have a community, you know, and you will find your own links to Los Angeles,
yeah,
hopefully.
And create contacts.
And create new contacts and new work, really, also. And hopefully that inspires new work for later on.
Mm-hmm.
You need a working visa, and that needs to either be organized by your employer, but mm-hmm. that gives you already a harder chance to get a job. from Americans, where they don't have to organize that and pay for it. So mm-hmm. For a residency, it's a bit easier because it's limited. Or for a teaching position.
So you can have the experience of working here through a residency program.
For a teaching position, visiting artist teaching position at one of the art schools, potentially.
Or you can try to have a scholarship like you did.
Yeah, for example, at the Getty Research Institute. I mean, all of these are very competitive.
Yes,
so you have to compete with whomever, you know, in the world. But
Well, so I hope that many more Austrians make it to Los Angeles.
I hope so too. I'm happy to help where I can because it's exciting to share things together.
Yeah, thank you.
Right?
You have already helped a lot, and I know we will have more projects. Maybe not the two of us, but but the Consulate General in Los Angeles and Doris Berger at the Academy.
It sounds so official.
So thank you, Doris, for coming.
You're welcome.
I know you came directly from the office.
Yes, I did. Thank you for inviting me. It's a pleasure talking to you. And also, it has been a pleasure to be working with you all this time, years now, and to knowing you and to be part of the network community that you have created since you've been here. It really was very enriching.
Thank you. Good luck for everything.
Thank you.
And see you.
For you too, in Vienna. Vienna or wherever.
Vienna or wherever. But in any case, soon.
Yes.
Thank you, Doris.